in my particular project, first of all, I am working on the Rosetta mission. So Rosetta is a spacecraft that was sent to a comet. And on board this spacecraft, IRF had an instrument measuring charged particles around the comet. And the purpose of this instrument was to study how the charged particles that are coming from the comet is interacting with the charged particles coming from the sun, so the solar wind. And in my particular project, I am looking at how the spacecraft itself has affected our measurements. You need to take the data afterwards and remove these influences that is caused by the spacecraft itself. So that is what I have spent the most part of my PhD project doing. Ever since I was a kid, I have found space really, really fascinating. And the first space-related memory I have is when I got a telescope from my aunt as a birthday gift when I was 6 years old, I think. And I also got some books about space. So growing up, I always thought that space was really cool. But it wasn't obvious to me that this was something that I would actually do and pursue as a career. So after high school, I actually studied music for 2 years, mainly because I wanted to do something else before I continued on at university. But then I always came back to this that, oh, but math and physics, this is something that I would really like to study more. And then I decided to still do that. So I think that it's really important that you just do something that you think is fun. And that's why I decided to study space, because I just found it really fun and interesting without thinking too much about where it would actually take me in the end, so to say. For me is, I think, just that you get to contribute to the exploration of the universe. I mean, there are so many things that we don't know yet, so many questions that are still not answered. And you really get to look at things that, I mean, no one has looked at before. And that is super exciting, I think. You get to meet a lot of people also from all over the world. It's a very international business, so to say. And this is also something that I really like about being in the space field. In the future, I would really like to continue on doing research, because that is something that I really enjoy doing. So I hope that when I finish my PhD, that I would be able to get a postdoc and then pursue a career within academia. So that is really just my dream, I think, to be able to continue on doing research that I'm really passionate about and like doing. To become a space scientist, I really think that the most important skill is just to be curious and interested and just wanting to know. Like, we have all of these questions, so many things that we don't know, and just wanting to find the answers to those questions. I think that's really the most important skill, just being curious. The biggest achievement that I am the most proud of is probably just the personal development that I have done throughout my PhD. Because during a PhD, you are being challenged a lot and you're really being pushed sort of beyond your limits, which leaves a lot of room for personal development. Like, for example, I've never really liked talking in front of people. I find that really scary. But now I can, stand at a conference in front of a lot of people and just talk to them about my research. And generally, you just find your confidence and learn to express your opinions and your views, and so you grow a lot during a PhD. So I think that's what I'm really the most proud of. Of course, I'm also, I mean, proud of the articles I have published and all those things, but I would say that really the journey that I have done as a person is what I'm the most proud of, I think. Just go for it, I would say, because I mean this is a really exciting and interesting industry, and we really need more women in this industry. So even though there are more women entering the space sector today, there is still a gap that needs to be filled. I think this is a very, very exciting industry, so I don't think they will regret it.